everybody. I already set up kind of like a smallish base, just using some TypeScript stuff and versify.js, which gives you like container. We're implementing a TTS bot from Twitch chat, essentially, which reads out all the messages and implemented these using Azure services. This is the one. Okay, this is going to be cool. I wanted to play with this for so long. I just haven't had the time to like actually do it. So this is what's really cool about this in Versify, right? I can mark this class as injectable, and then my bot class, do like private bot, that's there, and then inject these imports in. Now I don't even need a constructor. That's just gonna initialize this variable for me with my bot instance. We do still have to do some other minor things in here, and then we can container.bind TTS service. So I can access it via container, leave it to get. Then we can use this types dot, and that will give us our TTS instance. I guess we'll pass for the message maybe, and why not user state? We'll have a public handle method, user state and message. So user, I guess we'll just console log to say that we're handling it, just so we know that's happening. Okay, so I believe we can access username here. Yeah, we can. Okay, cool. I think we need to do some checks here as well. I think if it's coming from ourselves, I believe that's what that Boolean represents, then we don't want to handle it. Like if it's a bot message, we don't want to do anything with that. We're going to console log this if it is one of those, because I'm kind of curious what they could be if it just like randomly happens. Console log it, return. Okay, and we'll catch this error if there is one as well. We want to make sure that doesn't just explode and break things. I guess we begin by importing the library and then the speech configuration. I'm not sure what the type would be just yet. We'll figure that out in a minute. Type start. What did they call it? Speech configuration. Speech config. Okay, let's go with that. We're going to go in with SDK. Okay, we've got a lot of things here. This is kind of cool. Speech config dot from configuration. Okay, now these values, I guess we have to set these, obviously. We set these here. I guess we will copy these. Yes, that's that one. I really like this inject thing. It's really cool. No more needing to use a constructor, at least. It's kind of cool. What did they do here? Audio config dot from audio file output. Assuming we need to import audio config from microphone input from speaker output. That's cool. Let's go with audio.wav. So then you connect the two with the speech synthesizer. Now, I obviously don't want to basically just copy everything they've done, but at the same time, I don't know any of the references to this stuff here. So I need to kind of work for it. And then once we have a little something working, we can play and adjust and try and make it do cool different things. So we pass in speech config, which will be this speech config. Like this, we could also inject. I don't know if that's a good idea. But now we won't bother with it. That's a success, and then we have the error on the next one. I guess we'll just console the error if there is one, and we need to make sure we close it. Same here, Google fs has no default. It has a few values there, and this is files audio.wav.
Hello, I'm Azure TTS.
Oh, that's dope. I love it. That TTS voice is so like awesome.
Azure TTS.
Okay, we're here. Let's see if we can save it as an MP3 file. Maybe that will work. This one. Now just to...
Hi.
You could do... I think you can do no array in JavaScript. A map is probably a better idea. There's no way for TypeScript to know what values you're going to give it, because a map has... It has a key and a value, right? So how is it going to know whether your first value is a string or whether it's a number? For example, like with your generics, you can then say, so I want to take a string, but in here, I want to take an object. And then when it returns you stuff, if I did array get, for example, my first value, it's going to know it's a string. And if it's a number, it should pull me up on that like it has done. Well, let's see if we can change the voice. I think that's our next step, playing with different voices. So I guess it would be under customization, right? Custom voice portal. Interesting. Okay. So we have this. Whoa. Okay. There's a lot of choices. MP3 though. I guess this is the one I want, right? I'm going to go for this type. I think I can reference it this way. I can. Okay, cool. It doesn't like that though. It's a setter, and that is why. We change this as well, don't we? So maybe we can actually specify it as an MP3 file now. Let's try that.
I'm Azure TTS. Woohoo.
She sounds so cool. Okay. Does this mean that we can actually run this, F play.
Hello, I'm Azure TTS.
We can.
Woohoo.
Oh, that's dope. Okay, so we have that. I'm gonna assume it will follow the same naming conventions. Microsoft services dash content. Ooh. So we need this as well. MS REST is OJS. Okay, I think we need to register for the service on the Jill's side. So I guess we want to work with the response of it. We're going to have to deal with that. Our response theoretically will be this. We need to try catch it. Missing error. Change this bit up. And we're missing an R. Close it here as well. And then we'll implement the content moderation stuff. Okay, we got an error. I expected that. Okay, change these. And change these. Are those M's correct? Is our CM key? So CM endpoint location. Okay, let's do that in here again. Beach config. This one's gonna be, what's this one gonna be? Content moderator. Content moderator. Line. Okay. And then we are doing, okay, we just do a new, let's point this out. And this expects new cognitive services credentials, which means we don't actually need these in here. Now I think about it. We have the client created. Now we just need to implement it here. Before we get too ahead of ourselves, let's do one thing and extract speak text. Maybe we should pass in synthesizer and return this. I don't know if we actually need to return that or not. And then we'll take a message string. Now we have that. Before we do this now, we can do the text moderation. So let's just implement that here and see how that works. I believe we have to pull it in here first. Private content moderator. Now we can do the client, sorry, content moderator. Screen text, and we're going to have text plain as well because we're not doing anything special here. In our case, let's take this. We'll pass. What's that through here as well? Gonna have a response of some kind, which is gonna be, we've been in here a million times and I haven't even checked this. Do we have access to on this? Maybe with this, let's add a unspeak text method. And we'll just return here, pass through content. This also needs to be asynchronous, right? We're missing anything? I don't think we are. Okay, so if terms length is zero, then we're allowed to speak it, right? That's how it would be. Maybe here as well. Let's just log the response for one attempt to see what happens. And the message, is it going to error? False. No, no, it didn't. Yeah, it did actually. Cannot read property length of null. Okay, so terms is null by default. It's not an empty array. Your last message would have generated a MP3 file.
That would be nice.
That's dope, dude. I really like the Azure voices as well. They're so nice. Okay, so we kind of need to do something to play these, right? Essentially, we're using Azure services to implement their TTS. Then we've got a Twitch bot, which is taking every message in chat and generating a file for it at this moment. With that, we're also running the content through Azure's content moderation API to check if it contains profanity. But now I know that this command exists. We could theoretically just play it through this, do that. And we're gonna do, I guess, here. So I guess we'll need a file name. Files, and then we will have, let's import that please, or import it. So dot random bytes 16 maybe, mp3. We'll change this to path file path. Now this can be changed. Don't need to go super over complex, right? I just want the code to work, and we pass it into this one. File path would be a string, right? Oh wait, it's still got files at the start. Whoops.
Hello world.
I love the voices, dude. That's so, like, pleasant. I have speak text, although it doesn't actually speak it. Maybe we rename this to generate text, right? Voice file. And then we're going to have our private speak text, which actually speaks it. Messages to process or something? I don't know what to call it. It'll be an array of, we'll create a new type for this as well. Content would be a string. We'll have file path as a string. We'll have the user state, maybe we pass that through. So let's change this to get moderation result. We'll just add this check to our class instead. Change this. Whoops, fail paste. This, if we have terms, we're gonna return instead. I guess the voice file hasn't actually been created yet, but we have everything we need about it, I think, to create it. So I think at this point we can do this.bot.addMessage, and I say as message to process, and we need to fill it with all the stuff we need. So all of these parameters, let's just copy those, fill them out. We already have content on here, file path, we have that here, user state, we have that from the original message. theoretically we could, as a way to handle it, then it's a new promise with resolve reject. As long as we're returning the stream, it should theoretically be fine. And we do the synthesizer and just resolve it with this. At that point, it's created it. We send it off to there. Now we just need to tell it to speak. So with this, and I think it's unshift, message equals this dot bot dot unshift. Yeah, this has become a habit of mine and it's sometimes messing me up. It's shift, not unshift. At least I think. Message to process. Shift, can this return undefined? It can. We need to handle that because it could also be empty. Let's return and we'll just do console.log to let us know the queue's empty. See if we have any errors. Please work.
Hello world.
Let's try.
Testing.
Oh, that's awesome, dude. Oh, wow. It literally, yeah, okay. So we don't get our output until it has finished processing, but we have something weird going on here. These are singletons as well, so it won't know. And we have nothing to track the state of whether it's currently running one, so we need something for that. Message processor, export class message processor, and we can store all our stuff on here, and then it doesn't have to be as descriptive in this context because it's not on like a main class instance or whatever you want to call it. I guess we could change this to queued messages now. We'll do it under here, message processor, and our message to process here as well. We can put that on here and see why not. We'll remove this, and I will add here this bot. We don't need that. Yeah, and we'll pass that through that way, import this. This needs to possibly be null as well, be null by default. But then that means here we have to reset it, so I don't know if that's a great choice. I guess it's fine. Set it to null at the end here. And I feel like that will work in the right way. I guess we'll find out. We have to change this as well. And as for TTS service, this needs to go this step. But dot message processor dot, oh, we must have set it, change it to public. There we go. Moment of truth.
Testing. Hello world.
Hey, there it is. We'll call it with this. I wanna add more. I don't know what we can do without spending too much time. So I think we'll do it with this. I'm definitely gonna continue to work on this because it's cool. Make sure you check out Azure services for my first time using them. The TTS. You guys heard it. It's awesome. Thank you guys.